enemy really tried to take me out. He knew with his best shot knock me down.
Sticks out in my mind as a perfect segue into our continuing discussion about vision and the timing of God today. Mary Tyler, Dr. King said that she never thought that 50 years after the assassination of her father, she never thought in her wildest dreams that we would be fighting the same battles and addressing the same issues that existed in the infancy of the civil rights movement. And she also said that those battles that we're fighting are in similar to, if not worse than, social context today than they were back then. What she meant was there was a sudden shift from an Obama presidency where we were given the audacity to hope and shouted, yes, we can, to a Trump presidency where the atmosphere is make America hate again, and the collective commentary has become, oh, no, he didn't. He said, this has signaled to us, she says, that the time is now for us to realize that the kingdom of heaven suffers violence, and the violent take it by force. That we were so close, yet so far away. Just when it seemed that things were getting better here, as indicated by the election of the first African-American president, just as it seemed that we were moving forward in domestic and international policies so that we could live harmoniously together, up pumps Trump. And all of a sudden, we have to turn the hands of our clock back 300 years, where the order of the day is racism, bigotry, and misogyny. We were so close, yet so far away. In our text, then, we see again this whole scenario of being so close, yet so far away. For the nation of Israel has been in the land of Canaan for 5 years, and Caleb, the tribal leader of the tribe of Judah, has not yet been called forward to receive his inheritance. Remember what I told you last week, that the words of Jacob on his deathbed concerning his sons, Pompey, was that Judah would be first. That he would take the place of his older brother, his oldest brother, Reuben, because Reuben had slipped, and now the favor fell on Judah. I wish you would touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, I really can't explain the favor that's on my life. All I know is that what somebody else didn't appreciate, God saw me and counted me worthy to get it. Is there anybody in here who, before I go any further in this message, can shout about the undeserved favor that you got on your life? Is there anybody besides me who could just lift your hand and tell God, thank you for giving you things that you did not qualify for? You were at the back of the line, but it found you. You were in the middle of the pack, but it sought you out. Somebody ought to lift your hand and open your mouth and shout, Lord, I thank you for favor. Favor that don't make no sense. Favor that I didn't earn. Favor that I don't deserve. Favor that I didn't work for. Somebody ought to shout favor in this place. And so it is that Jude finally, Caleb, steps up to claim his family's portion of God's promise to Israel. And he makes a very interesting request when he steps before Joshua, when he steps up into Joshua's space, when he comes to ask for what it is he wants. An 85-year-old man requests a mountain, watch this, where giants live. Now, this may not make any sense to you until you understand that when you survey the scriptures, it was in Numbers chapter 13 that the presence of giants caused the people to be afraid. And because they were afraid, they would not move any further into promise. An 85-year-old Caleb who said, at 40, I got the promise. And 45 years later, I am stronger now than I was back then. He says, here is what I want. Give me this mountain. Somebody ought to shout, this mountain. My brothers and my sisters, I have found, as we're talking about vision and the timing of God, I have found that most often the timing of the manifestation of the vision of God for your life is signaled not by comfort and ease and seamless change, but when it is your time and when it is your season, you will know, watch this, because by what it looks the same, watch this, and difficulty is at a heightened level. Let me say that again. You will know that it's your season, not by how easy things are going. You will know that it is the timing of God, not by how undifficult things are. But you will know that it is your time when there is still difficulty. And watch this, the difficulty is at a heightened level. Listen to what Caleb says. He says, Joshua, here's what I want. In light of the fact that I'm 85 years old, I need you to give me a mountain that I have to climb, because there are giants there that I've got to fight. It was the giants in the last season of us trying to move into promise that really scared us and caused us not to move to the next level. Now, Elder Greer, I understand why it is so dry, depressed, and heavy in here. Because there is a sense of knowing that if you don't get what God has for you, that you gonna have to fight, that it ain't gonna be easy, and that the devil ain't gonna turn over and lay down and die. So I know I ain't preaching to everybody. I am not preaching to people who are weak spiritually. I am not preaching to people who are spiritual wimp. But I'm preaching to people who, like me, who straight from the hood, and still got some fight in you, and still can remember what it was in your last season that kept you from moving into what God has for you. Am I talking to anybody in here who ain't forget how to fight? I wish you would touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm saved, I'm anointed, the hand of God is on me, the Spirit of God lives in me, but I still got some fight in me.
Y'all miss what I said. The door is open, and we know that it's the difficult, watch this, and have been more difficult, our God, than they ever have been. It is your season, it is your time, it is your hour. If the devil is talking louder, if hell is getting hotter, if things are going crazier than they've ever gone, it is your time, it is your season, it is your hour. If it looks like the devil is swelling,
understand.
understand that the Anakim were the inhabitants of the mountain. They were giants. They were well over 8 feet tall. They were huge, so huge were they that the spies who saw them but were not saw by them said that we can't take it because they are there. Y'all gotta catch this. We can't move in it because we consider them to be our obstacle. We consider them to be too big for us, to be too strong for us. They saw the giants, but the giants didn't see them. All right, I got 15 minutes and 18 seconds. Can I help you to understand, y'all, that whatever it is that's been keeping you out of purpose and destiny is bigger in your mind than it actually is? I said, whatever it is that's been keeping you from going to the next level is bigger in your mind than it actually is. Y'all miss what I said? It was too heavy for a Sunday morning. They saw giants that didn't see them. If the giants were so bad, I wish I had a witness, the giants would have destroyed them while they were in the land of promise for 40 days and 40 nights. If they were so smart, they would have sniffed them out. If they were so smart, they would have found out where they were. But God knows, I wish I had a witness in here, that God caused them to be hidden. I wish I had somebody here.
Watch this, because there are generational demons that have run.
emotional disorders. He took their mind or tried to get it because it's only temporary. To see if he could take mine. And no weapon formed against it.
Dignifying you with an answer. You're like Hezekiah.
prophet has come in and told you, set your house in order. For today, you're getting ready to die. And you've turned your face to the wall. And you've reminded God, God, I ain't that good. But I sure ain't that bad either. And you made me some promises. And I need to talk to some parents and some leaders in here. I was parenting when I did not feel like it. I stepped out when he wouldn't even come around. I took care of these babies by myself. I don't have a maternal spirit. I'm a father, I'm a man, but I had to handle these children and raise these children the best way I could. And God, it seemed like you were nowhere around to assist me. You're the curse breaker for your generation. Babe, that's why it ain't getting easier, man. That's why I don't stop calling our name. Some of you who are single, that's why the one you thought was the right one wasn't the right one. Good guy, just not good for you. Good girl, she just wasn't the one for you. I said, this is bigger than just companionship. This is about right companionship. Watch this. And breaking the curse of failed marriages off of your family. That's why it bothers you so much that you're following the pattern. Your life is following the pattern that your mama and your dad's life is following. Temple, I want to say this to you. God showed me so clearly what demon we need to defeat. And I want to thank those of you who stuck around. And I promised the day before yesterday, as I was riding, he showed me. I said, Lord, thank you for giving me another chance. And with every day I have left, I will tear down that altar. And defeat that demon. Grab your neighbor's hand, please. You've been anointed to run the giant away. I want you to squeeze that person's hand. What time is it, both ways? Would you squeeze that person's hand? Y'all know, I don't like to put nobody on the spot, but there's some of you who are in your seat right now who know you need to be here. Watch this. For your family. See, here's the problem with many of us. You know, I got to preach today at 11:30. I don't even know the name of the church, but what was the name? Yeah, I got to preach to you in the church. I got to preach today at 11, so I got to get out of here. But one of the things I'm going to talk about, watch this, son. One thing I want to talk about is this whole concept of intercessory faith. And many of us think, y'all got to catch this, if it's all right with us, then it's all right. But God has been elevating you in this season. He's been opening doors for you in this season, not just for you. So it's going well for you now. You think you can take time off? Can't take time off now? Because what God promised you ain't just about you. Some of you don't have time to say, as long as it's well for me, my fault, and no more, we okay? Can I tell you why you ain't got time? Because this ain't just about your family. This is about your generation. Somebody else needs to be at the altar before you lose what you got. God will take it from you to take you back. Y'all better hear what I'm saying. To take you back to the very
So you are in active recovery, but Bud and Bobo and Lily and Queequee, they still sleeping in houses on dirty mattresses with no heat. You finally got somebody who will love you and accept you for who you are. With Aunt May and Uncle Ron still dying of a broken heart. If I'm talking to you and you in your seat right now, y'all know I'm not a prophet of gloom and doom, but God says, get to this altar before you lose it. I'll take it from you to show you where I need for you to go. He says, I'm allowing you to persist in this hard time because you are the Caleb.
Storm and the rain,
So much pressure, heartache, so much pain.
Yeah.
I've been broken into pieces, maybe.